What's going on, Instagram? This is AM Mindset. Brought to you by the one and only Fernando motherfucking Gatto. Welcome. In the meanwhile, let's burn an incense. Cleanse out the environment. Because energy sticks, you know? There's a lot of energy, a lot of entities out in your environment. You gotta clean out your environment. You gotta own your position, own your space. You see, this is why if you're in a household, you wanna keep the household pure. You wanna keep the household clean. When there's arguments in the household, when there's fighting, confrontation in the household, that stays, that energy stays in the household. So that's why each man and each woman must have their own sanctuary, their own safe place. And for most people, it's their room, you see? My room is very spiritual. My room is my sanctuary. This is my safe place. This is where Fernando Caro gets to express himself in each and every way, right? And so whether you're a business owner, whether you're getting ready for your job, whether you're getting ready to go meet the world, make sure you set some time in your sanctuary, in your safe place, to work on your mind, to work on the ideas that you're going to operate and entertain on this day. You see, your mind is the most precious commodity that you have. Because wherever your mind is paying attention is where your energy will be going to, right? And you want to safeguard your mind. You want to safeguard your energy. As if you had two large, or choose any dogs you want. I choose to have two large pit bulls in my mind, protecting my mind. Protecting my mind from the inferior bullshit that life's gonna give me. You see, my friends, we live in planet Earth, right? And the more we look out there, the more we start to realize, like, man, what the fuck is going on out there? It's easy to get consumed in the drama of life. It's easy to get consumed in the problems of, you know, your daily life schedule, your work, your relationships, your environment, your friends and family. And a lot of the times, most people haven't handled the toxicity of those around them, right? And so make sure that each and every morning you set some time for yourself to work on your state of mind so that you can go after this motherfucking world. Not afraid, not pussyfooting around. Declaring exactly what you want and showing up to the arena of life with total certainty, a total focus to say, hey, I have a fucking vision and a purpose and an aim today. My aim isn't in 5 years, in 10 years. My aim is today, motherfucker, and I'm here. And you start to claim and own your space. What does that mean? Own your fucking right to be here. Own your right to speak in your environment what you feel, what you want, what you desire. Why? Because we have this fucking mechanism called an intelligence, words that we live off of. You see, your life is dictated based on your ability to communicate. Realize this. Take a moment to realize this, for real though. That everything in your life can only be experienced to the amount that you can communicate. You see, if you're in a relationship, your relationship is only as good as the ability for you guys to communicate and understand each other. Because it's through language and words and communication that we get to know each other's mind. You see, there's six people on right now. Six people who are opening up their mind to my words. But see, there's a reason why people are here. Because my words have meaning, substance, energy behind it. There's life force behind it, right? So how many people in your life are you around that their words drain your energy? Their communication makes you feel less, makes you feel small. Fuck all that shit. We're not here to be Serbians to anybody. We're here to live a good life. At least I am. A good, strong, healthy life with an ambition second to none. So what do you want on this day? You gotta ask yourself. You gotta ask yourself, what am I seeking out on this day? What is it that I want? What do you want? What are you here for? What's your mission on today in planet Earth? Because it's your story, my friends. If you're alive, this is your story. So what do you want out of your story? Not the story that they gave you. Not the story that you grew up poor and you didn't have money. And now you're barely making by. Not that bullshit narrative story. Not the story that you grew up fat and now you are these insecurities. Not that fucking story. Who the fuck are you? You see, my friends, we have the ability to communicate who we are each and every moment. So stop painting the story that you don't want and start painting the story that you do want by speaking your values, by speaking your desires. Speak into life exactly what it is you seek. You see, I'm here sharing my mindset. And by me sharing my mind, some of my mindset and my words and my ideas, what happens is that those who can resonate to my message, those who can resonate to my communication, will then vibe in the frequency of my communication, right? And from that point forward, relationships are created, duplicates of me are created. You see, we live in a mental universe. As much as physical there is, as much as I can hit this wall, I can see all this stuff. You guys are watching me off of a material item, a cell phone. But the reality is that we live in a mental universe. You see, each and every one of you has your own perception of life, has your own image of life, is interpreting my words with your own filter, your own understanding of life. So my friends, you're living in your own fucking mind. Now, just as you would protect yourself if someone tried to grab you, or if someone tried to take possession of your body, if someone tried to, you know, say, hey, your body's mine without your consent, that would be a huge violation. And the same must be true with your own fucking mind. There's too many people who think that they have a rightful position to just take real estate in your mind. Fuck that. No, you don't. No, you don't. You take zero possession of my mind. But we have to safeguard our mind with ideas that amplify our character, make us strong so that we can awaken to our truest ambitions. You see, mankind to our core, to our nature, isn't negative. We're not these toxic motherfuckers. We're not that evil that's been done to us. We're the pure, raw goodness of pure motherfucking potential. Why carry yourself any less than your potential? It's a damn disgrace. A damn disgrace to worry about life. A damn disgrace to not show up to the arena of life and give this motherfucker all you got. For all I know, this might be my last day, so I'm gonna run this shit. I'm gonna own my position. I'm gonna claim to the world exactly who I am. And as I speak for you. I speak for you because you're here watching me, right? And the same that you guys are perceiving, the same substance of words and confidence and aura that I'm portraying out to the world is easily accessible to you too. The minute you step out of your bullshit, the minute you stop fucking making excuses about your life as to why you can't, as to the problems, as to I'm gonna see Sandy at work today and she's gonna fuck up my day. Why fuck Sandy? I don't know who's Sandy, but fuck Sandy, alright? Truth be told, this is that the outside cannot dictate how you feel on the inside. You see, most people are hurting internally. Because if I were to ask you right now, is someone physically hitting you right now? Is someone physically punching you, hurting you, touching you? Chances are no. But if we look in our mind, if we look in our heart, there's these internal tugs at us, these internal resistances that are hurting us. Why the fuck are we being hurt by our own mind and our own heart? You gotta ask yourself, who's robbing you of this experience of life? Who's robbing you of this shit? Who is taking possession of your mind and your heart and they're not physically hurting you? Why are we being hurt on the inside, where the inside is my kingdom? This is my wise dome, my wisdom, my wise dome. These are our temples. We have literally two temples on the side of our head. We must protect the purity of our fucking temple, our kingdom. and stop letting the outside forces infiltrate. You see, you start to own your life when you start to see how great you really are. When you start to see the fucking miracle of life. This is a goddamn miracle that we're alive right now. It's a damn miracle that I'm seeing the sun, that I woke up today. For the last, I don't know, I probably slept 4 hours, 5 hours. Where the fuck was I at? Like literally, where the fuck was I at in the last 4 to 5 hours? And then I come back all disoriented and have to like shake out my mind because my mind's saying, hey man, just go back to sleep, bro. No, shut the fuck up. I gotta get up. I gotta take my cold shower. And I got a mission to accomplish today. You can just shut the fuck up in my mind. You see, the mind starts to create these voices and these things that it tells you what to do. No, 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 mind. You don't know me, motherfucker. You don't know me, motherfucker. Because truth be told is how many people are in your mind. The voice of your mom, the voice of your father, the voice of your upbringing, the voice of your experiences, the voice as to why you can't have money, the voice as to why you can't find love, the voice of your betrayals, your backstabs, the voice of your insecurities, man. Fuck all those voices. Who are you? Who are you? You see, I only know you based on the way you decide to carry yourself and the way you act and conduct yourself. I'm gonna judge you based on the way you treat me. How about that? That I'm gonna start by trusting you. Why? Because I trust me. I trust me. So for that fact, I can now trust the environment. Now, if someone's character is against or they break the threshold of trust, then I'll judge you based on your character. I'll judge you based on the way you're acting. Not what he said, not what she said, not what they've said. Man, fuck all that. I'm gonna judge you based on the way you carry yourself, the way you treat me in this environment. If you're a kind person, a good person, then I'm gonna treat you with the utmost respect. You see, we gotta put these datums in our mind so that we have a filter of moving through life. We go through this life thinking that people are trying to attack us, trying to hurt us, and maybe that was the upbringing you grew up in. But I'm here to tell you, people are only treating you the way you treat yourself. We all have a tolerance level. Now, what are you tolerating about people? You see, I can tolerate when people misbehave. Truth is, I can tolerate when someone misbehaves because I can, in my mind, see, is this person a good person or a bad person? Did that act come out of a spite of intent of hurting someone or harming someone? Or are they just acting out of character, out of their behavior patterns? Well, in that state of mind, I can now reason as to why, how I'll treat others. Now, the reason why I'm talking about that is because a lot of you guys go to jobs you don't like. A lot of you show up to the arena of life around people who you didn't choose to be around. And so it's easy to get caught up into the mess of others. It's easy to get entangled with the energies of others. But what's your energy? What are you here to represent? Hey, I represent the energy of giving it all I motherfucking got, an ambition second to none, godlike confidence. I'm here to represent this entity of Fernando motherfucking Caro with everything he motherfucking got. And damn, that's a lot of motherfuckers, but those shits amplify me, all right? Now, who are you? And what are you expressing? What's that energy inside that is just ready to explode? Because my friends, the way you're being, that's just the way you've always been. But what if I told you? What if I told you that you could be anything you fucking wanted to be? You didn't have to be that insecurity. You don't have to be that depression. You don't have to be that anxiety. You could be anything you fucking choose to be. Like if you just really understand that right now you can be anybody you want to be. I get it. Some people know you a certain way. Some people in your life know you a certain way. And the minute you start to switch up and you start to tap into your power, the minute you start to rise up and no longer tolerate low level frequency, the minute you start to say, hey, I want better for my life. Hey, I can't tolerate little dumbass conversations. I'm here to change the threshold of life. I'm here to elevate my state of living. I'm here to be the perfect representation of what a man is, of what a woman is. I'm here to represent planet Earth as what a human being should be, right?
Here you are.
So ask yourself, how do you show up to the arena of life today? And that no matter what, you do not break character. And that's where we really get to see who you are. It's in the moments of most distress. It's in the moments where there's so much shit around on the outside that it can't even affect you on the inside. Now, I'm not saying I've ascended or transcended to the highest levels of fucking Zen and shit. No, of course. But that's the practice, my friends. It's a practice of life. It's a practice of growing, of evolving. I think that mankind is simply on the mission to evolve in being the most perfect man or most perfect woman in their respectful right. Because truth be told, I don't think people wake up and say, hey, today's another good day to fuck up my life. I think that we all want to do better. We're all here trying to achieve. We're all here trying to ascend. But the minute you start to buy into the bullshit of your mind and those fucking excuses, my friends, you go back to your bullshit. We can't tolerate that anymore. There's people who rely on you. Just look in your environment. Look at your mother, look at your father. If you don't have a mother and a father, look at your friends, look at your communities, look at the things that drive you. They need you. They need you to be strong. They need you to stand up and be the best version of yourself. If it's not for you, it's for them. And if it's not for them, it's for you. Whatever it takes. Whatever it takes. All right, that's it for this AM mindset. That was a good one, right? I'm gonna end this. If you guys have any questions, I'll give it for about a minute or so. We had some good people on here. Oh, we have some really good people in here. If not, that'll be it for this live. Actually, I got a class. I got a lecture at 10, so I gotta go. Salute.